हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ इन दिस न्यू चैप्टर करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी लेक्चर नंबर 1 विल स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर सो कॉल्ड द करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. एज यू हैव डिफाइंड, वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स व्हिच कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द चार्जेस एट रेस्ट. चार्जेस इन मोशन विल गिव यू इलेक्ट्रोडायनामिक्स एज यू हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिज्म. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस when charges are in motion gives you current. So we will consider now charges in motion. What happens? How can charge moves? Whether charge can move directly inside conductor or outside conductor? And what is the velocity with which it can move, by which you can get the current? Various aspects we'll read in these chapters. And this is also a very important chapter. In first class of this chapter, we can take the introductory class. And in introductory class, your fundamental first should be strong, what is current, because at the last of this chapter, some students ask, sir, whenever we are giving switch of electric switch in our house on, jette bele tame electric switch on karucha, light is glowing. Question is, what moves? Charge moves or current moves? That remains ambiguity till the end of this chapter. So in the first class, I want to clarify this one. Now here, I have given the heading current electricity, lecture number 1, in which I have given electric current. You may ask me, why should you write the electric current? Is there any other current? There are other currents. Current is not meant for electricity. Current is a very common English word in which we can get something in motion. Something in motion gives you current. Water during flood in heavy motions, high speed motions, called as high water current. We tell sometimes water current becomes high in that case. So when air moves with very high speed, we can say air current. So water current, air current, anything in motion gives you current. When charges in motion gives you electric current. You may ask me, how can you feel it? Who can say, how can you feel the electric current? I can never feel the electric current. And some tells, ame electric current khaichu. Is it a food that we can take it? No. We can feel an electric shock. Whenever we are touching the electrical line, or if you can have an experiment, whenever we touch by mistake an electric plug in open case, we feel some shock inside your body because the particles inside the body vibrates. There are certain particles which are conducting particles, iron particles or calcium particles or any other particles, blood particles, which can vibrate. We can get a shock. We can get a shock, got a current, we can say. That's why we'll define electric current first. So charges in motion, charges in motion gives you current. You may ask me, how can you explain charges in motion? I will explain in the next lecture number 2, mechanism of flow of current. That is a very important aspect, how the current actually flows inside a conductor. So charges in motion gives you current. Let us take very fundamental first. And if you consider, say there is a section of conductor across which so charges flows, then we define electric current I is equal to charge by time, as you have read this in school also, and this Q is equal to Ne, because we have read in electrostatic the quantizations of charge. Any charge is the integral multiple of fundamental charge. Any charge will be integral multiple of fundamental charge, means it is N times the electronic charge. It is 1.6 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb electron charge. 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. N is an integer. N is integer, and we have read it in quantizations of in charges in electrostatics. That's why this is Ne by T. This is the first formula for electric current. This you know from school. Now another formula you do not know from the school actually, that current is produced inside a conductor when charges will be in motion. When charges moves, then only there is a current. As we know, anything in motion gives you current. Now you shouldn't ask me, how can you explain the motion of charge? I'll explain it later on. Now, if charges flows at a uniform rate, uniform rate, I mean, this is true when charges flows at uniform rate. Uniform rate. Okay? But uniform rate, I mean, across any sections of a conductor, say in first second, say 10 charges moves. In next 1 second, same 10 charges. Next 1 second, same 10 charges. Next 1 second, same charges. There is a uniform flow of charge. If there will be uniform flow of charge, then only you can apply this formula. Current is equal to charge by time is very common formula. But whenever charges flows at non-uniform rate, non-uniform rate, then we define the instantaneous current as you have defined the instantaneous velocity and instantaneous acceleration, and that is written as dq upon dt. This is equation 2, this is the equation 1. And by taking these two, we will discuss the entire chapter. First, your idea should be clear about what is electric current. First, I am telling now, electric current is due to, you see, is due to motion of electric charge inside a conductor. But sometimes we tell current moves. Generally in school, what you have read from plus to minus, you are connecting the battery like this. So here is a battery and here is a resistance and this is plus minus. You give the direction like this, you say current moves. But current moves is not a correct word, we can say. Then what moves? Charges moves? No. In this sense, let me give you examples. Now you take a number of cycles in a cycle stand. Number of cycles in a cycle stand, one after another, very close to each other. Now there are 100 cycles. Now you are here at the first cycle. There are 100 cycles in a queue. You want to disturb the last cycle. Then you are the source of energy. Whether you will move to disturb the last cycle or the first cycle will move to disturb the last cycle? No one. Whenever you are pushing the first cycle, the last cycle falls. Then question is, what moves? Then energy is transferred from cycle to cycle. You are giving the mechanical energy to the first cycle. Thus energy is transferred from cycle to cycle. So that energy reaches faster. Whenever you are giving electric switch on in your house, something is transferred to the electric bulb. That's a bulb glows immediately. Not that charges moves immediately or current what moves immediately. Current is not a vector at all. So we will discuss details about this one. But first you should know the definition. When charges flows at uniform rate through a conductor, you can apply the formula current is equal to charge by time. Charge is integral multiple of fundamental charge. That's why you can write Q is equal to Ne upon T. And if charges flows at non-uniform rate, then you can find out the instantaneous current. Instantaneous current means current at any instant, at a particular instant, time. Then I, as you have read in instantaneous velocity acceleration in kinematics, limit del T tends to 0, del Q upon del T, it is written in mathematics. In mathematics, it is written as dq by dt, derivative of charge with respect to time. Here charge varies with respect to time. The flow of charge varies with respect to time. If charge flow varies with respect to time, then you can apply this formula. If charge moves steadily, we can say at a uniform rate, you can apply this formula. I will take these two formulae to solve some numericals to show you some concept in this case. Before that, these two formulas should be taken into consideration. First, you have got the formula. I am removing this one. These two formulas should be taken under consideration, nothing else in today's class. First, one formula is equal to Q by T equal to Ne by T. Second, that is dQ by dT. That is for charges flowing at a uniform rate. This is for charges flowing at a non-uniform rate. That is instantaneous current. And here, I will utilize these two formulas to solve these two problems given in the right-hand side. Before that, यू शुड नो करंट इज गिवन बाय दिस फार्मूला. करंट इज चार्ज बाय टाइम. चार्ज इज अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी व्हिच पजेसेस ओनली मैग्नीट्यूड, देयर इज नो डायरेक्शन फॉर द चार्ज. टाइम इज अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी, देयर इज नो डायरेक्शन फॉर द चार्ज. स्केलर क्वांटिटी बाय स्केलर क्वांटिटी बिकम्स अ स्केलर. दैट्स व्हाई दो वी आर टेलिंग दैट करंट मूव्स लाइक दिस, दिस हैज नो डायरेक्शन. दैट्स व्हाई करंट इज ए स्केलर क्वांटिटी. बट वाई शुड यू टेक द डिरेक्शन ऑफ करंट? नाउ आई एम कमिंग टू दैट पॉइंट. द डिरेक्शन इज हाइपोथेटिकल. नाउ हियर यू कैन सी अनदर एग्जाम्पल. से नाउ व्हाट इज द डिरेक्शन ऑफ करंट? डिरेक्शन ऑफ करंट, करंट इज ड्यू टू फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज. कैन यू से व्हाट आर द चार्जेस एसोसिएटेड विथ अस? ओनली यू नो द चार्जेस इलेक्ट्रॉन विच आर फ्री. Protons cannot be free. There are two types of fundamental charge inside a metallic conductor, in a wire, in your house wiring. And there you can have only free electrons. Free protons are not there. That's why whenever you are having some electrons moving in these directions, this is equivalent to motion of positive charges in these directions. The motion of electron from right to left is equivalent to motion of positive charges from left to right. Remember, positive charges can never move. Positive ions can move. In electrolytes, you will read, in ionic, when gas is ionized, in chemistry, I think you have read, when gas is ionized gas, there you can get the positive ions. Positive ions are formed when electrons are removed. So positive ion can move or electron can move. In electrolytes, also in electrochemistry, I think you might have read, positive ions and negative ions can move. Protons cannot move. Protons are very much rigidly tight inside the nucleus of any atom in any metal. That's why here the motion of electron from right to left is equivalent to motion of positive charges from left to right. And we give direction of current in the directions of positive charge. This is the directions of current, and here the electron moves in these directions. Electron moves, and here proton positive charge is hypothetical, moves in these directions, and we give direction of current by convenient in the direction of positive charge. That's why it is called as conventional current. After completion of the chapter, some students ask, sir, what is conventional current and what is current? See, the current which you are telling all the times in electricity is this current, convention. This is our convention to give the direction of current opposite to flow of electrons. See, the direction of current is given in a specific directions, not in arbitrary directions, just like a body can move in arbitrary directions. It is given all the times opposite to flow of electron. Since it always given opposite to flow of electron, we can say this is the opposite. Electron moves in these directions, we give the current in these directions. Electron moves right to left is equivalent to, by convention we can take, motion of positive charges in opposite direction. Just I am giving a small example. You say, I think you have gone by bus re jaicha. And there are some windows, you can look through the window when bus are in motion. Bus is moving in these directions. You are sitting inside the bus, you are looking through the window towards the trees and electric poles. And you will see that the trees and electric poles are moving in certain directions. But they are not moving, they are fixed. You are moving. If you are moving in this direction, they are supposed to move in this direction, but they are not moving. It appears like that. And that's why the motion of electron from right to left is equivalent to motion of positive charges from left to right. We have chosen the convention, we the Indians, we have chosen the convention that we give the current directions along the positive charge, best way to tell, opposite to flow of electrons. If you asked a question, what is the directions of current? You can say it is opposite to flow of electron. Okay, over. Now, that's why whenever you give the current direction like this in generally you give like this. This is a conductor. So this is a negative charge. Electron moves in this direction. You give the directions in this positive towards negative. Hello, opposite to flow of electron. This is the directions of current you are giving. Opposite to flow of electron. We have taken that convention. Over. I think your idea is covered. The directions of current is opposite to flow of electrons. Remember, inside a metallic conductor or in any free space, we can say. Now, again, question is, what are the types of current? Some tells there are two types of current. We know DC current, AC current, but generally types of current, types, we give one steady current, one varying current. This much. Steady current means steady current. I can plot a graph. This is the time, this is the current. Now, if current does not change with respect to time, say this bunk idla. So this is this does not change with respect to time. This becomes constant. There is no variation. That is called a steady current. And direct current, DC, direct current, which we call is DC, is an example of this one. Now, what is varying current? Varying current may be like this. This is one varying current. This is one varying current. The current which changes with respect to time is varying current. But this varying current is of no use for our case. And we give the varying current. This is an example. This alternates. And that is also varying current. And given as alternating current. Alternating current, we call it AC. Okay. Now, this is, there are two types of current. One is steady current, one is varying current. And the current which remains constant with respect to time, there is no variation. We can steady current, the blue line is steady current, direct current example. And the current which changes with respect to time will be varying current. And these are the examples. Alternating current is an example of varying current. And we will have a separate chapter for this. Alternating current and electromagnetic induction. Now, here we will consider everything taking this direct current into considerations. Now, let me summarize the class. First, today we have read charges in motion gives you current. How can a charge move? We will discuss in the lecture number 2. Second, the current when produced, the motion of free electrons actually charges, and we give the direction of current opposite to flow of current. Electron, that is our convention, that is conventional current. Current may be steady, current may be varying. Okay. Now, in this case, here current charges when flow at uniform rate, we get this average current. When charges flow at non-uniform rate, that means charges, flow of charge varies with respect to time, varies. Flow of charge changes with respect to time, then dq by dt can be calculated. Let us see certain examples. First example, one. First, I am using this formula. See this question number 1. First question, an electron gun, you can see there, an electron gun emits, gun means electron gun, just like a bullet can be emerges from the gun, electron can be emerge, can be immersed from the gun itself. Immerse, that is called as electron gun. So, electron gun emits 2 × 10⁻⁶ electron, 2 × 10⁻⁶ electron per second. That means number of electron, that means here number of electrons is 2 × 10⁻⁶. Time is 1 second. That's why I think you can find out. I think I didn't find out this one. I is equal to q by t. Q you can take n e by t. N is given. E, I think you know 1.6 × 10⁻⁹ coulomb, and time is 1 second. So you can substitute n as this number, time as 1 second, e as this much. You can calculate this as for the question number 1, you will get that answer. And whenever, see, you will get the answer like this, 10⁻³, you can write 3.2 milliampere. Some students confuses with this milliampere, 3.2 milliampere. Okay, I think your idea is clear. 10 to the minus 3 ampere, you solve it. You can put the values, you will get this answer. Okay, second process you see. Second question is slightly important. These are direct questions I have given in the first one. According to this formula, let me take this formula into consideration. Let me take the second formula. Example number 2. And this example number 2 and 3 will be of some importance actually. Here you see the example number 2. The amount of charge, passed in time t, the t is arbitrary time, through a cross sections of a wire, cross sections means as this is a wire, you can see the red stripe you can see, that is a cross section through which the charges can flow. Now the amount of charge passed in time t through a cross section of wire is this much. Charge is given, that means charge varies with respect to time. If time changes, charge changes. That is, we can say the varying charge changes with respect to time. So that find out the value of current at instantaneous current, t is equal to 5 seconds. This is the answer. How to do here? Here you can utilize this formula. Q is given 5t square plus 3t plus 1. So you can find out I, you can take the derivative. I think you have read the derivative. 5 into t square 2t plus 3, I think you know the derivative. Those who do not know actually the derivative, they can go through the derivative, write the formula, and you can see the answer here. 5t square, 5 constant, t square derivative with respect to t is 2t plus 3t with respect to t is 1 plus this is a pure constant 0. I think you have read in derivative in the first year, that is 10t plus 3, that is the current at time t, and t is given 5 second. So t is 5, so I is equal to 10 into 5 plus 3 equal to 50 plus 3, 53. I think you know the unit of electric current, I didn't explain this one. So unit of current is ampere, and you can get this ampere, 53 ampere is the current when t is equal to 5 second. So I have utilized these two formula for these two types of numericals. And another type of numericals, we can get an important fact. See, I think now your idea is clear. When you can apply which formula? Whenever you will be given the total charge or number of electrons n, or number of charges you can write, number of charges, general electrons, then in time t, then you can find out this average current. But whenever charges will be given, when varies with respect to time, flow of charge varies with respect to time, that means in 1 second, the total number of charge is not equal to total number of charge in 2 seconds, total number of charge in 3 seconds, the charge will cross over a section. So whenever charge will cross over the section, the crossing over the charge, total amount of charge does not remain constant all the sections of times. It changes with respect to time as per these equations. Then you can utilize the derivative dq by dt to get this result. Now reverse questions can be asked. Question is, what is reverse questions you see? This is also an important question. See, I think you should be very much attentive in current electricity classes, such that I think if you listen all the words going out from me, you can answer plenty of short questions. So you should be very careful. You can listen, if you want, you can listen twice to get some sufficient base in electricity for first 1 to 2 classes. Now here, number 3. In this, the current, let, I am writing the questions, and these questions also I have given in the notes as well as the materials. Also, this is a question from H.C. Barma, I think. These questions, the current through a wire, it is charge was given. I get the current applying the formula I equals to dq by dt, because charge is given with respect to time. Here, reverse I am giving instantaneous current at a particular time. You have to find out the charge. by integration method. The current through a wire at any instant is given by say I0 plus alpha t. I do not know what is I0, I do not know what is alpha. I0 is say given, alpha are given, and data that I am giving to you, I0 is given 10 ampere and alpha is given 4 ampere per second. These two data are given, this given. And question is, let current at any instant of time t is given by I equal to I0 plus alpha t, where I0 is a constant given by 10 ampere means 10, alpha is a constant given 4 ampere per second. Directly it can be also given 10 and 4 in problems. Now question is, find charge Q at time is given through a section in a t in 10 seconds. Okay. Again, you see the question. Current at any instant through a wire, through a conductor. Current at any instant t across this conductor is given by this equation. And find out what is the charge across that section flowing in 10 seconds. In 10 seconds, what are the total amount of charge flowing across this one? So in 10 seconds, we have to find out. Time is given 10 seconds. Let us first find out the charge. How to find out? Same formula should be adopted. So here I equals to dq by dt. This implies that dq is equal to I dt. I think you are able to follow this one. I is equal to dq by dt. Dq is equal to I dt. Now you integrate it. And you can put the values also. I equal to I0 plus alpha t, you can take the bracket into dt. Now you have to find out the charge. You have to find out the charge in 10 seconds. First you find out the charge. How to find out the charge? You can integrate it. Dq integrations, I think you know on the q, I think you might have read the integration. Dx integration is x, that's why dq integration is q. So dq equals to I0 dt integration, I0 dt integration plus alpha t dt integration. But I0 is constant. So that I0 is constant, you can take it out. 10, I0 is 10 ampere, I think. Let me see, just a minute, good. I0 is equal to 10 into dt plus alpha is 4 t dt. I think you have read the integration. Dt integration is t plus 4 t dt integration is t square by 2. I think you know this formula. I need to explain this one. Dt integration is t. T dt integration is t 1 power t square by 2. That's why in 10 second time, t is equal to 10 into 10 plus 4 into 10 square. 10 square is 100. 100 by 2. That means that I am writing in this side. 10 into 10, 100 plus this is 2, cancel with 100, 50. 50 into 4, 200. This much. And answer is 300 coulomb. Answer is 300 coulomb. That means this formula can be adopted if flow of charge across any sections of the conductor, across any section of the conductor when charges flow, if varies with respect to time, then you can find out current if charge is given by differentiating the charge. If you can find out the charge if current is given, you can find out the charge by method of integrations. Okay. Now today, we actually have discussed very fundamental things. What is current and how can you feel the current? You can feel yourself. I can feel it. If you want to feel the current, you can touch an electrical wire, you can feel it, but don't touch it. यू कैन गेट एन इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉक, SHOCK, शॉक. यू कैन गेट एन इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉक बिकॉज द पार्टिकल्स इन द बॉडी vibrates. Just like I have explained, if you disturb the number of cycles, the energy is transferred from particle to particle, just like in wave motion. So what is transferred actually in electricity, we'll see in the next class. In current electricity lecture number 2, we'll consider the mechanism of flow of current and the velocity with which the electron moves at room temperature inside the metallic conductor, and whenever an electricity or battery potential difference is applied across the conductor, what is the speed of that electron, and by which we will define mechanism of flow of current, drift velocity, expression of drift velocity related to electric current. Okay, we'll see this in the next class, in an introductory class. This much. Thank you all.